r/AskReddit. Which villain actually had a good motivation? The hyenas from The Lion King. Hunger is a powerful motivator. Wow, never thought this through before. I always stopped at Scar as the villain with the motives and the hyenas are just the henchmen, or henchlinus. The parallel with the Nazism is even more striking now. It's just a hungry mob who did what they thought was the best way to escape their miserable condition. The machines in The Matrix. The second Renaissance showed that it was humans who struck first and tried to destroy the sentient machines once they became intelligent. The machines removed themselves from society and created their own city 1-0 in the middle of the desert to try to allay human fears, but it still didn't work. Humans were the aggressors. The machines wanted to protect themselves. And the machines are not even evil. Instead of just exterminating humans or chopping off their heads and using their bodies as batteries, they took the trouble to create a massive virtual world for us. They even tried making it a paradise at first, according to Agent Smith. But we rejected it, so they went more realistic. Yep, I think the first machine city was 0-1 inches. Ed Harris's character in The Rock. Ex-vet wanted a decent funeral for some of his fallen comrades, plus I think a 100 million compensation for their families. Spoiler alert. The president said no. I always thought this was one of the most powerful standoff scenes in cinematic history. General Hummel, Commander Anderson, if you have any concern for the lives of your men, you'll order them to safety their weapons and place them on the deck. Agent Paxton, this is not happening. Commander Anderson, sir, we know why you're out here. God knows, I agree with you. But like you, I swore to defend this country against all enemies. Foreign, sir, and domestic. General, we've spilled the same blood in the same mud. And you know goddamn well I can't give that order. Navy SEAL, we're dead. General Hummel, your unit is covered from an elevated position. Commander, I'm not gonna ask you again. Don't do anything stupid. No one has to die here. Commander Anderson, raising his voice, you men following the general, you're under oath as United States Marines. Have you forgotten that? We all have shipmates we remember. Some of them were shit on and pissed on by the Pentagon. But that doesn't give you the right to mutiny. General Hummel, you call it what you want. You're down there. We're up here. You walked into the wrong goddamn room. Commander. The Grinch. Loud ass hoes. To be clear, the Grinch didn't hate Christmas. He hated people. Which is fair. Semicolon Jim Carrey. He was just sad because they bullied him as a child. Prince Zuko. Before he sided with Team Avatar, all he truly wanted was to go home. Have the respect of his nation. And the love of his father. Having recently re-watched the series, I would argue he never was a villain in the show. Yes. He was an antagonist to the heroes. But he was much more of a secondary protagonist. We are privy to his journey from the start. General Admiral Zhao fills the role of villain in Season 1, Azula in Season 2, and Oze in Season 3, when he finally moves into the spotlight. Mr. Freeze. Specifically BTS Freeze, which eventually became Canon Freeze because that story is so damn good. But yeah, he's one of the best answers for this question. Think of it. Batman. To never again walk on a summer's day with the hot wind in your face and a warm hand to hold. Oh. Yes. I'd kill for that. Mr. Freeze. Guy just wanted to save his wife. He does the crimes for funding, right? Surely Bruce Wayne. Man with so much money he probably sweats it. Can throw a few GS at the guy to stop the crime. Anakin Skywalker just wanted to save his mom. Then his wife. Fear is a powerful motivator. And Palpatine knew this. Obviously the genocide is unexcusable. Anakin was rescued from slavery and no one. Not his rich patron the princess. Not his Jedi master, not any of the so-called good guys. The Jedi Council. Ever went back and spent a few measly credits to buy his mother from slavery. They left her to die on that dusty a-hole of a planet. And then what does his patron do? Why, she enters into a sexual relationship with this child who has no family support he can turn to for guidance. Anakin never stood a chance for a normal life. Magneto. Having been a Holocaust survivor, it makes a lot of sense to not want to see the people you identify with once again persecuted for the circumstances of their birth. Plus, he was right. That's exactly what happened. And he proved it out time and time again. can't agree with all of his methods, but he was 100% correct that it was mutants versus humans, and always would be until one group is gone. True, I think one of his problems was not realizing the depth of humanity within mutants. Even if normal humans were eliminated, all human characteristics and emotional traits would still exist in mutants. Greed, envy, jealousy, compassion, cultural differences, conflicting ideologies. Eliminating humans wouldn't automatically unite all mutants under a banner of brotherhood. Dr. Doom. He has literally, like without a shadow of a doubt, seen every single outcome of every single decision he has or will ever make. And the only way humanity survives is if he rules them and takes them on a certain path. Yet the ducking Fantastic Four keep on beating his ass down. His rule isn't even that bad. Even in the context of a great leap forward, the FF just don't like him because he is just a power-hungry single leader, and being that and ruling the Earth has historically been bad. But you know what all those other populist leaders didn't have? Literal demonstrable clairvoyance and super intelligence. Dr. Defenshmirtz. His parents didn't even show up to his birth. He just wanted to be a good dad to Vanessa because his parents were never good to him. Squidward. I'm Squidward. I'm Squidward. I'm Squidward. 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 Roy Batty. He just wanted to extend his life beyond a mandatory termination date. Tyrell was the real villain. Also, the principal from Ferris Bueller. Bueller was doing exactly what he suspected he was doing and is kind of an arrogant prick the entire time. Ozymandias from Watchmen. Needless to say, his methods were atrocious, but in the end his goal was basically world peace. Do you seriously think I'd explain my masterstroke if there remained the slightest chance of you affecting its outcome? I did it 35 minutes ago. That line was a major jaw drop. First hero film where the villain won. Control Freak in Teen Titans Go. He wants them cancelled. Edit. Thanks for nearly 2k upvotes. That's the most valid motivation I've seen here. Sandman from Spider-Man 3. He just wanted a chance to see his dying daughter before she died. The only reason he robbed places was to get enough money to find treatment for her. He accidentally killed Uncle Ben, and felt really bad about it, to the point where it haunted him. The real villain was the American healthcare system. Dr. Horrible. He saw the lies that were being spread, the fact that those in charge were harming humanity, and wanted to make a change which, okay, put him in charge, but also led to actual change for the people. Also, Captain Hammer is an a-hole. Part 1. So cute and funny. Part 2. Ooh, getting a little dark, but wow, I still like it. Part 3. Sobbing. Just sobbing. Wartness from Monsters Inc. His world was on the brink of an energy crisis. He was just trying to find new ways to get that good scream energy. This was true until he chose to stand in the way of renewable, sustainable energy sources to protect his own company's short term. He researched better scream extraction when he should have had a bigger R&D budget devoted to finding new paradigms entirely. The EPA guy in Ghostbusters was just trying to make sure their weird new technology was safe, but the quippy nerds refused to comply. Turns out they didn't even have a backup generator for if it ever got unplugged. Yeah, but he was honestly a dong in Die Hard. Team Plasma from Pokemon, specifically N. Their plan was to liberate all Pokemon from their trainers, by either convincing the trainer to release their Pokemon, or by theft. I think Getus was actually evil and just using the liberation of Pokemon thing to get people on his side to help him. Vader. The Jedi were basically puppets at this point. They talked about being all for peace and whatnot, but the Senate votes for war and they're completely okay with being the generals in this war. They were okay with taking command of an army made up of an entire race of slaves bred specifically for military service, who will be executed if they leave. They pretend they're for democracy, but in the Clone Wars series, one planet decides of its own volition to join the separatists, and the Jedi and their slave army shows up to murder them for this decision. And you look at the separatist argument. The Senate is corrupt. Yeah, they had that one spot on. Sure, the separatists were also being led by the same people corrupting the Senate. But that doesn't negate their argument. And also, the whole slave thing, it runs a lot deeper than you probably realize. The Jedi themselves are basically a self-perpetuating group of slaves. They take kids at an early age and indoctrinate them, and if they leave, they are shunned, if not straight up murdered. In episode 1, Keegon says something like, "I didn't come here to free any slaves," and this general thought comes up a few times. At the time it sounds like an in-the-moment description of their current situation, but looking at the bigger picture I think it is more indicative of the overall Jedi position on slavery. So is it really any surprise that the guy who was a slave as a kid turns against these a-holes? Luke Castellan from Percy Jackson. His motivation was that the gods didn't pay enough attention to their kids, himself included, and wanted the gods and Camp Half-Blood to recognize the children of the minor gods. I would agree with this one, but he goes further than recognition when he wants to completely eradicate all the gods and demigods that don't come to his side by freeing the Titans. In the first book I'd agree, but with the latter ones, not so much. Even he realized he went too far when it was way too late. TBF, it's been a hot minute since I've read the series, so I might be glossing over some. Megatron. He just wanted to save his own species. Bearing in mind I've only seen the Michael Bay movies, no comics cartoons. I'm coming from playing the War and Fall of Cybertron games. His intentions were to return Cybertron to its glory days, but had a really shitty way of going about it. Dude started a global war, expending what little energon was left, and then the Autobots opted to just leave the planet for Megatron to do as he pleases, cause Cybertron is basically in stasis lock until a few thousand years. But Megatron wanted them to stay and suffer. Ice King. My boy Funny Valentine. Mojo Jojo from Powerpuff Girls. Everyone remember that time that he got beat up just walk down the street? Yep, I swear there were times he was just out buying bread and they'd show up and beat the shit out of him. Ghost from Ant-Man and the Wasp. She wanted to save her life, she didn't wanna hurt anyone. Zemo from Captain America Civil War. Superhero battle, kills everyone he cares about, destroys his city and sets his country back to the Stone Age. Then they just go home. Zemo targeted the Avengers and set them up to turn on each other. A man with no powers was able to beat the Avengers. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.